What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my Let's Play of Shovel Knight. I think there is just one more thing we have to buy, so we might as well buy that. But I could be severely mistaken. And you never know. So I generally am severely mistaken. I think it's from this guy. Anvil. Yeah, so we do have to just buy this one. And I think that should be all the upgrades and stuff that we could buy. I think decked out. Okay, cool. What's this one do, though? Well, I don't want to get rid of that one that has that bonus attack to it, because that's amazing. Is there some protection for higher magic? Oh, what is the... Oh, wow. Damn, 150 instead of 100. That's kind of a big change. But the one I like is this, so I think I'll keep that on. We just wanted to get everything we could. Now that we've done that, I think that we're probably ready to see about maybe beating this game. I don't know. As I said before, I kind of expect there to be something else after this. But let's go ahead and jump into the Tower of Fate. This is the much-storied tower where we lost our shield-bearing companion an undisclosed amount of time ago. I'm not really sure. Boxed myself into a corner there. Well, that... Okay. So it's enemies from all the stages, pretty much. Am I slipperier than usual, or what's going on? Okay. So that's weird, because you can just... Wow, that was really bad. If I was back a little bit farther, I would have been in trouble. Okay. Well, should... I mean, at this point in the game, we've got so many powers. There's not really much reason. So I was looking at... Oh, wow. Okay. That was almost really bad. There's not really much reason not to just use them all. Do what you can with those. Damn. I was looking at some of the achievements. Some of them are pretty hard sounding. A couple are really silly, but they seem to add a lot of difficulty to the game. And as I've been talking about for most of this game, I haven't been too stressed out with the difficulty, which I was a little upset about. Oh, they expected me to hit these guys, I guess. I was like, how did they expect you to get through that without the... Oh, these things. Oh, one of these Griffin dudes. I liked these Griffin dudes a lot. I did not die, okay. Thought I might be kind of boned there. That is very forgiving that it allows you to go back to where you were at in the last screen or whatever. I think that actually if we just do this, we can probably just kill this guy really easily from over here. And it goes through this lava. I was kind of worried that it wouldn't, but it seems to, yeah. Seem to have plenty of time to do that, but not plenty of time to get hit like that. Oh, dear. Bombs and everything. It's a pretty cool stage. Looks like there's a lot of different... Oh, damn it. A lot of different ways that we can get through stuff here. Using all of our skills and things, and, you know, just kind of killing ourselves, because I didn't realize what kind of blocks I was on. Only four sections to this one. I assume that means that it's just a little bit harder. There's a little bit more space in between them instead of it meaning that the stage itself is shorter. So I would assume these stages will be a bit longer than... That's just that same enemy, so we don't really need that. It could have been health as well. I don't really remember if we had health or not. I'm gonna keep the platforming helper here. But like I was saying, it seems that there is a lot of added depth if you're going to try and do like a platinum run, which I don't really know. What do you call those in Steam? Nobody really truly cares about Steam achievements. I do. I like all of Steam's little... I don't know what you want to call them, but all their little trappings to get you to play all the games and do all the crazy stuff. I actually really enjoy them because I like the Steam achievements. I tried to do that the right way, and that obviously did not work out well for me. And now I have to go all the way back. I love the trading cards. I think those are really awesome. I'm not quite sure why I enjoy them so much, but I think it's a really cool idea. They just seem to mean more than... Well, they definitely mean more because they unlock stuff for you, and that's always what's been missing from achievements, was unlocking stuff, which is what I think is awesome, kind of cool about, since we are playing this and not on a Nintendo console, but it definitely came out on Nintendo consoles. I think that's kind of what's cool about their whole sticker thing, and I really don't even have to deal with this guy. I'll just... do this and get past him because I already killed him once. I'm really lucky that I didn't take that damage there. And if I can kill this guy fast enough, I'll be able to get all my money. I think. that didn't work out well. I wonder if I can capture that money again. I don't know why I'm so worried about the money, because the money doesn't even really matter anymore. I mean, you get some achievements for having like $50,000 or something like that, or 50,000 gold rather. But at this point, it doesn't matter. I just got the achievement for buying everything. So there's nothing else to use this money on. So I can kind of just... Actually, looking back, that's the only reason that you really worry about anything in this game, is to get your money back. So I think that we probably can just kind of speed through this stage. Unless I do stuff like that. I could have used that item to get back over to the other side. But I did not. I chose not to. I decided that dying there would be much more dramatic. I really like this green background that we have to look at. I think it's quite beautiful. And I want to enjoy it for as long as possible. So we're just going to do that. And this, what's really cool, is what I think is speedrun potential. Can I jump to the bottom of these and I just never noticed? Speedrun potential for this game is really cool. I don't do speedruns. I've been talking about speedruns a lot in my Let's Play of 1001 Spikes as well. And I think that I'm going to probably try to fully complete that game. I heard it's not too hard to get the times down enough, but for actual competitive speedrunning and stuff like that, it fascinates me. It's not something that I think I'd be good at. It's not something that I really do, but I think it's really cool. I think speedrunning is really awesome. I mean, they've got those games done quick things that they do often, and I enjoy watching those. Yeah, I shouldn't have hit him. That's obviously what happened there. Like, I can just... So that's the weird thing, is I could kind of just plow through this whole game by using... Yeah, that's what I figured. By using this thing, and not even really have to worry about killing anybody or doing anything. So I hope there are some mini-bosses and stuff like that that we have to worry about. This is obviously... Can I phase through that? Probably not, right? It's probably down for too long. Oh, damn. Well, it was nice of them to put that checkpoint there. Oh, crap. Oh, God, how low does this go? Okay. All right. Damn. Okay, does that go all the way down, or am I safe? No, because you can die there. Okay. That is pretty complicated. That's cool. That's kind of the tougher platforming that I've been looking for. Is this going to come all the way down? No, it's not. This kind of sucks. You have to be... You can't do it then, but you got to be ready to go here. Can you make this jump? Oh, God! That was close. We got some spikes. We've got a trap. Balls. That crouching does jack shit for you. It's probably just life or something. We do have to pick up all of the lyric sheets, though. I am still on the lookout for those. I think that those are a pretty cool collectible... Because they unlock something like in-game, and that's always what I'm about when I'm searching for collectibles and stuff, is actual in-game content and unlocks that are a result of that. It's one of the reasons why I'm so into, like, the Shin Megami Tensei games and stuff like that, because a lot of the bonus garbage that you do gets you, like, more powerful demons and stuff like that, so... What the hell could I possibly have done wrong there? I was holding down on the shovel... Like, I'd have to go frame by frame and see how that thing possibly in the name of hell hit me. Because it seems pretty improbable that I just straight... Damn it, got hit by that thing. No, that's a really bad idea. I was thinking about just trying to do it on the way up, but that seems really stupid. You gotta be careful with this jump, though. Same stupid enemy as always. Kill him. I mean, I guess, but they just come back, right? It wouldn't make a whole lot of sense if they didn't. At least eventually. No, they don't. Those guys are one-trick ponies. I never knew that. I guess I should have tried that earlier in the game. I just assumed that they would, that there was like an infinite spring of them down there, and they would just keep coming back to kill you. All right, so there's that. What the fuck did I do that for? I didn't even realize it until I started going. That hidden room is going to be a real bitch to get to. That better have something in it. like a lyric sheet or something. Yeah, it's still really stupid. I think this through a little bit more. That was almost very dangerous of me. So they've got no relic runs built in, which I really do think... I mean, I'm a collectible hound. I mean, I love getting all the collectibles in a game. So that's kind of why I did it in this one. Because generally, you get all that kind of power-up stuff. Like in Mega Man X, I made sure that I got all the best armor and everything like that as soon as possible. In this game, I kind of feel like the power-ups work more like the newer Mega Man games item system, where they make the game easier for you, but you don't necessarily have to pick them up, which I think is kind of a strange way to do it. I'm gonna try and get this, and I swear to God, if it's something stupid, I'm gonna be so pissed. I knew it. Okay. Just gotta be real careful here. Alright, we're doing it now. I'm keeping tracked. Balls. So you have to go down there and then come back up. Okay. Alright. We can't just phase through that, right? Because then I'm the worst person ever. Because if I can phase through getting crushed, it's not something that I really want to try. I tried the spike pits out, obviously, because that's something that's going to affect you long term, but I don't think getting crushed is really going to come up again. I don't really want to try it out. I feel like I'm a little slidier than usual. I don't know what that is. It could be, I don't know if the rain is a mechanic or not. I doubt it. I'm kind of surprised there was no cinematic at the beginning of the stage, considering he's been trying to get to this tower for ever. So as long as we've known Shovel Knight, he's been real crazy about getting in this tower. And now he's finally doing it. Because it was sealed before. Alright, so we've got that music sheet. We don't have very many of the music sheets left to get, actually. We're doing pretty good with that. Alright, so I gotta do this. I gotta come around here, but... No, I should be fine. There we go. Okay. Just had to be sure to punch that. And now we should be okay. We should be able to just this ride this up, right? Okay. Got a carrot here. We've got more crushing action. All these kill you. Super. And I get to deal with this dick. Fine, let's do this. Balls. There we go, made it through there. Seriously though, there isn't a whole lot of reason for me to kill stuff anymore. Dick. Whew. Okay, that was scary as hell. I guess there's a checkpoint right there, so. Checkpoints are closer together than I expected them to be, considering that there's only four. The beginning of that stage was pretty long though, so. What are these things? Holy crap! Freaking samurai gun all of a sudden. See, I might do... I don't know if I'd do it on film, but I think that it's pretty obvious that I... There's a lot of stuff about this game that you don't get on your first playthrough that I want to experience again. And I might do some of those runs to get some of those trophies. I don't know if that's something that I would ever record. It might be something that I live stream if I ever... go that route and start doing that kind of stuff so you can run over short gaps. I'm kind of scared that this will fall, but it doesn't, obviously. I gotta ride this down. That was terrifying. I was really close to the spikes. Kind of expected to get boned. More of these samurai guys. Have most of the enemies had unconventional weapons? Because these guys have, like, real... Not real weapons, but not that a shovel is not a weapon in the proper wielder's hands. These have more potentially well-known tools of destruction and mayhem. Is this fake? Why? Okay, I can... Doofus. There's a trophy for this, too. Get back over there! Okay, there was no sense in me doing that, but I was really scared. Oh my god, respawn rate like a son of a bitch. There's a fake wall over here too, obviously. Oh, damn it! There's just been tons of enemies. These fake walls are real sons of guns anymore. I really don't like dealing with these archers. Cool enemy design, though. These guys are really neat. I'm just gonna run through this guy real quick. Okay. Did it. Okay. I guess we could have dropped down there and got more gold or something, but... kind of okay with what we did right there. I don't really... like I said, we don't really need the money. Oh my god, more of this garbage. Fine. Well, we should fish that because Troop LaBoople might have something for us. And also, I like the fact that even if it's deflected, it still counts. Well, I guess we don't need Troople, but this could be lyric sheet as well, or music sheet, so. And it was. Sweet. Hopefully we get all those without too much trouble. It's something that I've been trying to do, obviously. Got some ninjas, got some... or samurai. Jeez, I'm sorry. I'm sure samurai get that all the time. They absolutely hate being called ninjas. So there's no point of this that lights up, so I'm worried that there's going to be, like, false floors or something. But I guess I shouldn't be scared of that. Can only live in so much fear. I'm still pretty good on health, so we're doing okay. Just a little bit of that platforming difficulty that I've been looking for, so I'm glad we got it. See, here's some fake floors, and I'm sure that this is some part of this is fake, right? Oh, you can see the rain from that one above where it's falling right here. Yeah, we just gotta wait for him to... you can kind of stunlock that guy, which is strange. Can you not... yeah, you can't jump back up a bit. Because I'm kind of curious as to whether or not... because I don't really know why this guy would be here unless there's something behind him. Maybe food, which at this point I'm just screwing myself, so I don't know why I did that. I don't think there's anything to worry about. I'm doing all these tiny hops because I'm scared, but I still would have fallen down. Just watch the rain, I guess, yeah. And the rain, when it hits stuff, that's obviously when the platform is real. So some of these platforms are fake. What is that? Is that one of those propeller guys? Oh, son of a bitch. Wait, can you light stuff up with those? No, you can't. I'll keep that just in case we get more of these propeller dudes we have to worry about. What are those boxes, though, if those aren't real? Okay, got another one of these. I'm all right with that. Let's switch back out to this thing. So I think we're gonna have a mini boss. Okay, so this is Black Knight. Shovel Knight, stop your meddling and turn back now. This is your last chance. I will reach her, Black Knight, even if I have to go through you. Whoa. Oh, Enchantress showed up. Black Knight, are you guarding my tower? Have you finally decided to join? Wait, what? You may kneel and pledge your loyalty now. For the last time, I answer to no one. Why? Here's a tiny taste of my power. So she's going to make him buff and crazy, but why is he... if he hasn't been... wait, did she kill him? Is this like a zero moment right now? Oh, spoiler alert for... never mind, I just won't tell you the game. You'll never know. Black Knight, I warned you to stay away. What the hell is happening here? What is this game about? What is the plot of this game? Whoa! That's rad! Oh, I want to be able to do that so bad! Why is there not a dash in this game? Oh my god, this guy's so cool now! Oh, is he kind of a little bit of a mix of all the bad guys so far? Well, he definitely got me there. Holy shit. This is probably something that I should be using my... wait, can I shovel these? No? Stay the F away from those? Yeah, don't mess with those. You can knock those back? Wait a minute, did I just knock that back? Yeah! Got you, Shovel Knight. Black Knight, who's not Shovel Knight. I got you, because I am the Shovel Knight. Wait, what do you do? Whoa. I jumped that, didn't I? Damn. Holy hell. Oh my god, he is just demolishing me right now. Okay, I can't break those, only he can. Okay, I jumped that one. I get him to attack, right? Balls, why am I so obsessed with Scrooge McDuckying when I tried to use the item, but I did not do a good job? Gotcha. No, I didn't get him there. Okay. I don't know. I don't think that... Wait, is he doing, like, full feigns of damage to me? Because then I need to do this, and I need to start using this amulet more, and then I'll be able to beat him. This game's going to be a lot more fun when you don't have all this garbage. God damn it. Black Knight, you son of a bitch. What can I do here? Okay, there we go. Damn it. Okay, that does not do enough damage to be worth wasting all these... Wait, I've got this thing. Shit. He's just so far out of reach. Missed him again. What are those? Okay, it looks like I'm starting to get some hits in on him. He is impossible to hit right there, though. See, he's moving way too fast. Okay, we got him down to one hit, or down to two hits for me. One health thing, and of course he's gonna do this. Damn it, oh, you son of a gun. You've gotta be kidding me. Gotcha! Oh, shit. Crazy, that was awesome, that was a great boss fight. What is going on here, though? What is happening in this game world? That was my last toss, too. This has gone far enough. Whatever you've been trying to do, you can't reach her. Was he trying to kill her himself? You may be right. She may already be lost. He's talking about Shield Knight, right? Can't let go of hope, but now surely you see who I'm trying to save. I haven't tried anything beyond words. Her magic is so powerful. Wait. Whoa, plot twist. The Enchantress is Shield Knight? This is the best game ever. The dialogue of this game is superb. Absolutely top notch. You've got to be kidding me. Oh my god, that's so cool. There's got to be extra stages after that, too. There has to be. I'm going to go triple up. I should just get two health potions. Whatever blue garbage. What does this do? Sure. Great. Okay. Yeah, you can get... Wait, what? Oh, he's going to town. Okay. You just choose them both first. Fairly well, Shovel Knight. Okay. Radical. Thank you very much. That will come in handy. And I might as well go talk to my buddy in here and see how many of these... I'm obviously missing some, which is a shame. Of these... 32, though. Well, I don't know. We've got two to return. No, there can't be that many in the end. Last stage or so. You know, they've done studies. Reading maps was more fun when we had our freedom. Now that I have this music sheet, I can perform it for you anytime. Okay. Twelve balls. There's some little stuff that I can go around and do here that I guess I'll just do right now. I mean, I'll probably have a cleanup episode, but there are some little things that we can do. Like, we're supposed to... Actually, I don't know what they mean by one of them, but we're supposed to bounce on this for 5 seconds. Oh, shit. Oh, what the hell? Maybe that's really hard to do when it's on this catapult. No! Oh, balls. Well, whatever. That's exactly what I was trying to do. This is exactly where I wanted to be. Everything's going according to plan. 50,000 gold at one time would be a real pain in the ass to get, considering when you get hit, you drop it. Okay, thanks a lot for watching, everybody. I really, really appreciate it. Be sure to tune in next time when we figure out what exactly truly happened to Shield Knight and what's going on in this tower. This game, really well written. I've obviously had a couple of issues with the gameplay, but the writing is superb. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.